Hello, this is Barely Painted, and today I show you how to make DIY variable natural density filter. You may think this is very easy. Simply stack two CPL filters one on another and your variable ND is done. Actually no, this is not as easy as you may think. Here we have two problems. First problem is parallelization direction. CPL filters works properly only in one direction. When we place filter in wrong direction instead of dimming, we can see color shift from warm to cold and vice versa. Not very useful, at least for me. But when I change order, we can see a result what we need. But here another problem. Now we can't screw filters together. This is mean we need rotate the glass. Second problem is rotation. To do this in proper way, we need one fixed filter. For this we have solution. We only need cheap and useless filter, for example UV or protection filter. As you may know, all CPL filters have rotating front element, and when we place two filters together, it will be difficult to get proper dimming level just with one hand. We simply should move polarization glass into the frame from UV filter. We need to disassemble all three filters. At the first time it sounds scary, but in reality it's very easy to do. But not always. For this I use disposable prying tools. They're perfect for this task. You can also use special tool, but this is not necessary. On the front of the filter, you can find two grooves on opposite sides. Put screwdriver or prying tool into the groove, depending how well they assembled from the factory. This is a good idea, rotate whole filter clockwise, because this is much easier and faster way to get job done, at least in this case. Don't be afraid, scratch the glass. This is actually two pieces of glass and the thin foil between them. Notice, because filters is coated in some sort of paint, it is not a bad idea to keep them away from your lens and camera. In my case, two filters were loose and only one locked very tight. Next step is properly locate each glass. For example, if you put filters in wrong direction, you get weird results, as I mentioned before. Here I show you what I mean. In the first example, they simply don't work. At least we can change color temperature. This probably can be useful if you use film camera. And now we have continuous dimming, no matter how I rotate filter. Okay, now when we found the right direction, simply reassemble filters. Here how our DIY ND filter should look assembled. and here how it looks on the lens. Pretty neat as for me. Now some examples. In the first footage you can see that ND filter works very smooth and bokeh pleasant to eyes. But here we have another problem. When we push filter on extreme level, we can see uneven dimming, or sometimes it's called X pattern. Here you can see when footage is properly exposed using aperture blades. Bokeh is a hexagonal and not really appealing, at least for me. And now side by side comparison between ND filter and aperture. As for me, footage on the right side much sharper, but in the same time bokeh looks weird in comparison to the footage on the left, and adjustment is noticeable visible because aperture has hard stops. Hope you enjoyed this video. See you later!